Hello, and in this video I will be covering how to set up the analog to digital converter. First, let's go over the hardware. The B port of the PIC is connected to 8 LEDs. Then we have an FTDI USB to serial connected to the RX and TX of the PIC, and a variable resistor connected to analog channel 0, which I'm going to be referring to as the pot in future. Now let's have a look at the datasheet. It's a 10-bit analog to digital converter. The analog to digital converter has 5 registers associated with it. The result high register, the result low register, and then the control registers 0, 1, and 2. Now the first register we have is analog control register 0. In this register we select which analog channel we are currently reading from. We are only going to use channel 0, so it will always be equal to 0. The analog to digital conversion status bit, this is used to trigger a analog read by setting the analog bit. And then we have the ADC enable and disable bit. And then in analog control register 1, we have the voltage reference configuration bit for the positive and the negative reference point. After that, we have the mode select to set pins either as digital I/O or as analog I/O. Then following this table, we can see to set all the pins as digital, except for AN0 as analog, we need to write 0xE or this binary value to these bits. Then lastly, we have the analog control register 2. First, we have the result format bit, which just sets if the data is justified left or right. Now we are going to use write justified. This would mean that the least significant bit of the result register would sit in bit 0 of the lower result register. If we had it at justified right, the most significant bit would sit in bit 7 of the high register. Then we have our acquisition time select bits. I'm going to use an acquisition time of 8 TID. I can use, from looking at the tables, 2 times TID, but 8 TID should slightly improve accuracy. Then we have our analog conversion clock select bits, and I'm going to use oscillator frequency divided by 4, just for simplicity's sake. Then we go down. Then we have a mechanical diagram for the selection of the analog inputs and also the reference point for the 10-bit analog to digital converter. Any analog pin must be set as input via the TRS register. And this is the basic steps of running the ADC all the way from 1 to 5. I am going to use the polling method instead of waiting for an interrupt. You go down. This is equivalent circuit for the analog to digital converter. Some base values used to calculate the acquisition time, formulas for the acquisition time, and then we have a table which we can use to derive what we need to set our acquisition time as. As you can see, this corresponds to a value of 2 TID, but I bumped it up to 8. Now let's get to coding. I'm just quickly going to run up what the pre-setups are. I added stdio.h, so I have access to sprintf, just for formatting. Then I moved all the UART functions to a .h.h file. This is a reference for any data received via the UART, as well as this bool just to tell if we received, but these are not going to be used in this tutorial. Then a buffer for whatever we want to print out over the UART. Then our forward declaration of our high and low interrupt functions. Now we move into main. The section sets the oscillator to 8 MHz. We set the entire B port as output and set the entire B port low. Then I init the UART to have a board of 9.6K, and then I enable the interrupts. Then lower, we just have the high priority interrupt for UART receives, and nothing's happening in the low priority interrupt. Now to set up the ADC, we go to the main. We start with TRS, A bits, RA0 is equals to 1, set it as an input. Then we say our ADCON register, 1 bits, VCFG0 is equals to 0. This is our voltage reference positive source. Then we copy that. We change it to VGFC1, also to 0, to set our negative reference to the ground source. Then we configure our analog digital pin selects with ADCON 1 bits, PCFG is equals to 0x0E. Now we set the format of the analog output with ADCON 2, ADFM is equals to 1, so we have write justified. Then we set the acquisition time with ADCON 2 bits, ACQT is equals to 0x04. Then we select the clock source for the analog to digital converter with ADCON 2 ADCS is also equals to 4 hex. Then we select the analog channel with ADCON 0 bits CHS is equals to 0 to select in channel AN0 as our conversion point. Then finally, we enable the analog to digital converter with ADCON 0 bits AD on equals 1. Then we move to our infinite loop. In our infinite loop, we start with ADCON 0 go done is equals to 1. Now this will start an analog to digital conversion. Then we wait with a while loop until go done is equals to 0. And that will indicate when the analog to digital converter is done. Then after the conversion is done, we do sprintf. We take our print buffer, place that into sprintf. I'm going to copy the printout text I'm going to use, which is ADC read, two places format text, and then again, two places format text. Then I'm going to print out the ADC result high and low register with AD res H and AD res low. Some functions I added to the UART is just array print and string print. I'm going to use string print for this one. So, at my UART string print, you can reference to one of my previous videos where I set up the UART. Unfortunately, the string and array prints aren't in that video, but here's the setup for them. And we program the PIC. Get our PuTTY terminal. When I adjust the pot, the value will go lower, as indicated by the cheapo voltmeter. The hex value will go lower, and the multimeter will die after losing 3.3 volts. As I adjust, we see the value going lower, and the multimeter die down. And when I adjust the value up, the value will increase. Now for now I'm going to adjust it all the way to 0. Now I'm going to set the value of the LEDs equivalent to the reading on the analog to digital converter. So we start with a global variable of size uint 16, call it ADC to LED, and that's equals to 0. We say ADC to LED equals to AD result register high, shifted by 6 bits, close this in brackets, and then ORed with AD result register low, shifted by 2 bits. In case that in brackets, we say let B is equals to ADC LED. ADC to LED. Now what this piece of code does is it shifts the 2 bytes left in the ADC result register high and throws away the last 2 bytes in ADC result register low. And then these two values get combined with the OR function. This effectively changes your resolution of the ADC to 8 bits. So the equivalent of the B port. We program the PIC again. Now when I turn the pot up, the LEDs will start counting in binary upwards. I'm just going to turn down. So LEDs can get annoying after a while. Let's just keep one or two on. It's good enough. Now the last thing I'm going to demonstrate is how to convert the analog to digital to a human readable voltage. Again with a professional paint here. Now the formula we use for this is our reference voltage divided by the amount of bits we have in our analog to digital converter. So in this case, if it's a 10-bit ADC, it will be 1023. So our reference voltage is 5 divided by 1023. That gives us a resolution of 4.89 millivolts per bit, rounded up. Back to the top of the code, we add a define. We say 5.0, the 0.0 is important, divided by 1023.0, and we call it ADC res. Now we go down, we reuse ADC LED, put that equals to the formula above. Now we right shift the high result register by 8, and we leave the low register untouched. Then we go back to the top of the code. We declare a floating point. We call it ADC volt. It's equals to 0.0. We say ADC volt is equals to ADC LED times ADC res. And we copy our sprintf, we change the read to volt, add a formatter of floating point, make it 0.2, decimations, move to carriage return, we say ADC volts, and we copy our UART print, we program the PIC, and we grab the PuTTY terminal again. As you can see, it's showing 140 millivolts. Now, as we increase the voltage, you'll see on the terminal that the voltage increases. You'll see about a 3 volt that the voltage meter goes on again. And then at full voltage, you can see it's about 4.9-ish volts. Now, a better method is to take about 3 samples and averaging them out. And that's a basic introduction to using the analog to digital converters on a PIC microcontroller. Any hardware that I've used will be linked down in the description. They are Amazon affiliate links. Any code that I've written will be linked in my Git as well down in the description. A like, share, comment, and subscription would be greatly appreciated. Thank you. Have a nice day.